In this session, we'll see the remaining options in rectangle. Now let me go with rectangle. In the last session, we have seen the options after picking the first corner. Now we'll go with the options before picking the first corner. Now before picking the first corner, here we have few options like chamfer, elevation, fillet, thickness and width. So after applying these values, you can create a rectangle by picking two corners. Now before picking the corners, I am going chamfer. Let me go with C. It is asking the chamfer distance. I am giving the chamfer distance as 25. The first chamfer distance is 25 and second chamfer distance also 25. Then now if you pick two corners, directly you are going to have a chamfer for the rectangles. Now you can see all the four corners of the rectangle are chamfered. So this is how we can create a chamfered rectangle using chamfer option. And if you want with different dimensions, then you can go with rectangle. Right now you can read the current settings, the current modes, chamfer is going with 25 by 25. If I want to change the chamfer dimensions, I can go with once again C enter. First distance I am taking 20. Let me take the second one as 50. Now again you can pick two corners. And if you see now, we have the chamfer for all the four corners, but the chamfer distances are different. Now it is going with 20 by 50. So from the corner, it is going to calculate 20 on one line and 50 on the other line. So this is about a chamfered rectangle. Now once again, let me make the chamfer distance as 0. Let me go with rectangle, C enter. I am changing the first distance to 0 and second one also 0. Now next we'll see about fillet. Now instead of chamfer, if you want fillet for the corners, you can go with F enter. And because it is fillet, you have to specify the fillet radius. Let me take the fillet radius as 50. And now try to create the rectangle. Now this is a rectangle. And this rectangle is having the fillets at all the four corners. Then we'll see the third one. But before that, let me make the fillet radius to 0. Go with F enter. And I'm changing the radius to 0. Now we'll see the third one. And let us go to the third one as width. So go to W, enter. Now it is asking the line width. Let me specify 10. And this width is similar to polyline width. Already we have seen the width option in polyline. Similarly here also, it is going to apply the width for the rectangle. Now this is called the width. Then we'll see the fourth option. And let us take the fourth one as thickness. Now by default it is going with width. Now let me make width 0. I am going to W enter. Width I am changing to 0. Now we'll go with thickness. So I am going to T enter. And thickness I am giving 30. And now create the rectangle. And here the thickness will be added along the z-axis. But you can see here we have only x and y. So I am going to show you the thickness by going with z-axis. For that I am going to view. And in this you can select here 3D orbit. And using the left button slightly you can rotate the object. And here you can see this is the thickness which is added along the z-axis. You can see this is the z-axis. And along the z-axis the thickness will be added. So always thickness will be added normal to the sketching plane, nothing but along z-axis. You can go with escape. Once again, if you want to place this in the original position, then you can go to view, go with 3D views, and here you can choose top view. Again it will place in the original position. So this is about a thickness. Then next we'll see the last one. And the last one is elevation. Now this elevation is used when you want to create the rectangles at some distance from the sketching plane. Now actually here our sketching plane is nothing but xy. Now at some distance from the xy plane, if I want to draw the rectangle, then I can specify the elevation distance. So go with E enter. Now I am applying here the elevation distance as 200. Then we'll create here a rectangle. Then again I am going with rectangle. Now let me go with E enter. And elevation I am making 0. Then create one more rectangle. So first one is created with an elevation of 200 and second one is created with an elevation distance of 0. Then again you can go to view 3D orbit. Now whichever we have taken as 0, that rectangle will be placed exactly on the sketching plane. So you can see here, this is placed on the XY plane, whereas the second one is placed at a distance of 200 from the XY plane. So this is about the elevation. When you want to create the rectangles away from the sketching plane, you can take elevation and specify the elevation distance, then a rectangle will be created. Now let me go with escape. Again you can go with view, 3D views, and select top. Now go with rectangle. We have completed all the options. Now even if you don't want thickness, if you want to go back to the original rectangle, you can go with T enter and make the thickness 0. Now we can create an ordinary rectangle. So with this we have completed the rectangle. Now next we'll see the arc. And for this arc we have a shortcut, that is A. A is the shortcut for arc. And to create the arcs, it is better to go with the menu, because first we have seen even for the circles through the menu. Now let me go with draw menu. In the draw menu here we have arc, and if you go with this menu, it will give you the complete list of the different methods to create the arc. Now these are the different methods to create the arc. Now to create these arcs, better we'll take a rectangle and we'll use the rectangle corners as the points to create the arcs. So we are going to pick number of points to create the arcs, and let us use these corners of the rectangle as the reference points. Now this is the rectangle I have created, and let me go to draw arc. In that first we'll see 3 point. A 3 point arc means you have to pick 3 points, passing through those 3 points an arc will be created. So let me go with 3 points, pick the first point, pick the second point, and pick the third point. Now passing through these points, you can see here an arc is created. This is called 3 point arc. Then we'll see the next one. The next one in the arc is start, center, end. So here first we have to pick the start point, then we have to pick the center point, and then we should go with the end point. And let us do one thing, wherever we have the center, let us try to select the center point of this rectangle. In fact, center will be existing only for the circles, and directly there is no center for the rectangle. But if you want to snap exactly the center of this rectangle, then we can take the help of one more option called O-track. Now here we have O-track in the status bar. O-track means object snap tracking. So with the help of this O-track, you can pick exactly the center of the rectangle. Now I will show you how to use the O-track, then we'll go to the arc. First let me try to draw here a line. This is the line, and I want to draw one more line from this end point, so I can draw from the end point directly by picking. Then let me try to create here a rectangle using these lines. Now rectangle means both the opposite sides should be of same length. So when I want the bottom line should match with the top line length, then here I can get one track from the top vertex. Just you can move and you can get one track. And to get the track, let me switch on here O-track. Select the O-track and then go to the end point and slowly move towards bottom, and you can see now this is a dotted line we got. And this is called a track. And because this track is passing through an object snap point, it is known as object snap tracking. Now I can pick this point and then I can end here exactly. So this is how we can get the points from the object snaps. Now similarly, if I want to pick exactly the center of this rectangle, then I can get the tracks using the midpoints of the rectangles. Let us try to create one circle at the center of the rectangle. I am going with circle. Then let me bring from the midpoint, I want a track. So I am going with O snap settings. Let me switch on the midpoint. Then go to the midpoint. Just move the mouse. This is one track. Then again go to the side midpoint. Then move the mouse. Then where these two tracks are going to intersect, that is nothing but the center of this rectangle. So I can pick and you can create the objects. So this is about the object snap tracking. Then how to use this object snap tracking and how to create the remaining arcs, we'll see in the next session.